Right, and up. Please flag and roll.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
slice of lemon is on the plate to remind us of the bitter fate of those captured and missing in a foreign land. A pinch of salt symbolizes the tears endured by those missing and their families who seek answers. The Bible represents the strength gained through faith to sustain those lost from our country, founded as one nation under God. The glass is inverted to symbolize their inability to share this day's events. The chairs, they're empty. They are missing. Remember them.
Thank you very much, Bob. Please take your seats. Bob Page.
Sacrifices of you, our veterans, and your families. We are the beneficiaries of your courage, your sacrifice, your vigilance, and so are countless people around the globe. That is why today is reserved for you. We must seek out the war stories of today, what today's veterans have seen and heard, so that we are ever mindful, and I feel it so often, that our decisions to commit our nation to war are our most solemn, asking for great risk and sacrifice by those who answered the call.
You know, when we talk about veterans, sometimes we lose sight of the fact that veterans are people among us. They're our friends, they're our neighbors, they're our family, they're co-workers. And in their day, and in their way, veterans lead, sometimes we think, ordinary lives. But they're very different lives from all of us. They're very different because you all were called to sacrifice. Sacrifice your time, sacrifice your self-safety, sacrifice your family time, and you went to serve this country and worlds far away from where we are today.
To one of the highest points with our own Boston Red Sox. But what you see often is a lot of pride. And you know something, if you're in New York or you're any place else throughout the country, you're wearing that Boston Red Sox hat, the Boston Bruins, the Patriots, and recently, even the Celtics are coming back a little bit. But you know something, there's a special wink and a nod to that person. Let's make the commitment today, that each and every one of us is going to treat our veterans like that 365 days a year. That every one of us is going to look at these young men and women, the back left-hand side, and say thank you. Thank you to our future veterans for ensuring our safety. Thank you to our future veterans for making sure that we are protected. Thank you to our future veterans for ensuring that my family will always have the right to freedom of religion and the freedom of speech. Ladies and gentlemen, today is that celebration. That celebration like we've had throughout this great Commonwealth. Please join with me every single day when you see somebody with that hat, with that uniform on, and simply say, thank you. Have a wonderful day, and thank you to all of our veterans and to all of our future veterans.